Cast, are you just? Well, I have the pleasure today of having Steffany Hanlen, the Olympic coach, with me. Steffany, how are you?
I'm great, JG. Thanks for having me.
Well, listen, folks, for everyone that's tuning in, first of all, thank you so much for tuning in. And second of all, just be aware, Steffany is live on location. So you're going to hear noises, you're going to hear people, you might hear singing, you might hear
music,
you might see somebody in skates, I don't know. Steffany, where are you right now?
I'm in the Orleans Arena in beautiful Las Vegas, Nevada.
Very cool. That's great. So tell me, as an Olympic coach, you know, the Olympics are not for several years. What are you doing there?
And what am I doing?
How does this journey play into everything?
Well, this is the first event, Skate America, of six events that the skaters start to earn prize money and points towards Worlds and Olympics. So it's called a Grand Prix event. So it's the first one of the 2019 season. And we're using it as our first competitions towards the 2022 Olympics in Beijing.
Wonderful. That's fantastic. Now, for those people listening, Steffany was one of our keynote speakers at the ACRE Real Estate Investor Summit in Edmonton. Steffany, you absolutely crushed it, killed it, nailed it.
Thanks.
It was awesome. And you have made, I mean, you have moved earth and back to be at Vancouver. Can you tell us a little bit about what you had to do to be there? Because I so appreciate it.
Well, I'm not sure how my skaters are going to feel, but I'm going to be up 24/7 making sure that they're taken care of and doing a kick butt job at ACRE on the weekend of November 1st to 3rd. I was supposed to be at a Grand Prix in France. We have five teams, I believe, there that are competing, and it's the third Grand Prix of the season. And we talked and negotiated and figured out a solution so that I could be at ACRE.
Wow. Well, that's amazing. We're so thankful. So please thank your skaters and your teams and for being there.
I will.
Now, you are one of the, you have a powerhouse lineup in Vancouver, probably one of the best speaker lineups I've ever seen at any ACRE. I'm so excited to have you there. Let's talk about that. One of the talks you're going to be giving is on the champion's journey. Can you tell us a little bit about what that means as it relates to real estate investors? Because we understand it from an Olympic perspective. We understand it from a skater's perspective. But how does it relate to me as a real estate investor?
Well, there's really only one champion's journey, and that's the one where you choose to really take your game to the next level. So it doesn't matter if you're a champion real estate investor, champion mom, champion plumber, teacher, partner. It doesn't really matter. It's the mindset of being a champion that transcends all things, sport, business, life. So if you are operating on making a plan of being a champion in whatever it is that you do, then the first step is to understand that you are on a journey, and that journey needs to be supported in order for you to be successful.
Now, we are going to be bringing in, and what's going to be discussed throughout the weekend is a variety of how-to strategies and a variety of research fundamentals and a variety of stories about how we're doing it in the trenches of real estate investing. But Steffany, after you've been a real estate investor since 2000, year 2000, I believe.
Did you say for thousands of years? Is that what you said? No.
I would only say that of Patrick Francie, not of you.
Thank you.
But you've been a real estate investor since the year 2000. So how having gone through this transition for 19 years, how do you find that the mindset and this champion's journey is relevant to real estate investors who come to these events? They just want the numbers. They want the cash flow.
Right.
They want to get into that kind of nuts and bolts. How does that relate to you?
Well, it relates directly, because there is no true journey to the podium, for example, without some ups and downs and learning about how to handle adversity and how to overcome injury, how to plan so that you can succeed, you know, surrounding yourself with people who, you know, for me, what I did was I surrounded myself with people who were basically smarter than me. It's why we joined RAIN in 2001, so that we didn't know anything about real estate and we didn't have to. But then we had to train ourselves and treat ourselves like athletes. You know, what do I need to do to become a successful real estate investor so that the future state that Patrick and I were living into could exist when we needed it, when we needed to possibly start to sell or start to transition or exit out, you know, to make sure that the journey, when we look back at it, you know, had included what we wanted it to include. So that would be things like like-minded people, for example, a community, understanding that everything, when you do set a goal, you know, there is a podium out there. There was a podium out there for me. I just didn't know it was going to look like a portfolio that, you know, we could eventually start to pull properties out of or sell, et cetera, that would take care of us into our golden years, so to speak.
Now, I love to hear, and I think so many people misunderstand or don't have an awareness that to take an athlete like you do and to make them win gold at the Olympics is truly a team effort. I mean, they're surrounded, literally surrounded by people. I mean, probably dozens of coaches, professional
technical,
technical mm-hmm. that are helping them. Real estate is very much the same, isn't it?
Mm-hmm. It's actually the same. That's what it's so simple to me. You know, a community of like-minded people who are supporting you as a real estate investor or an athlete to achieve your dreams. Life's a team sport, you know, and that's what cracks me up when people think that they're just in the room at Rain just to, you know, find the next joint venture partner or, you know, close the deal, etc., which is the outcome or the podium, so to speak. But the journey to get there, man, that's the most fun. And that's where you get to discover who you are and what you believe in, what your stand is and what you want to contribute down the road. So it's not just about the nuts and bolts and the numbers. It's truly just, it's about finding your peeps.
Yeah. Now you talked about adversity a while ago, Steffany, and I think that that's fascinating because as real estate investors ourselves, we know that you can't achieve anything of greatness, especially real estate investing, without going through some ups and downs.
And so why not? Why not? I thought you just got to go to a seminar and pay 40 grand or something and it all happens. What do you mean? What are you talking about?
Yeah, exactly. That's what most people think. So adversity is going to happen. It's all about preparing. Yeah. And I loved your segment in Edmonton, which I know you're going to give us more of. And the stories you shared about some of the adversity your clients and your athletes have to overcome. I think that's going to be incredible.
Well, embracing adversity is a skill. It's a skill set. You know, we trained with Dr. Paul Stoltz years ago in adversity training, and being from the sports world, to me, adversity is normal. If nothing's going south, you know, something's wrong because it means that you're either not on the right path or there's something that you're avoiding, you know, and then, or what we say, you're stepping over something, you know, so it's slowing down and noticing what is going down, because my saying is something's always going to happen on the way to the Olympic Games, always. But it's what you do to prepare for it and then move through it. That's what a breakthrough is that you keep going through. You don't stop. So that's the gift of adversity, I call it.
Can you tell us a little bit about some of the stories and some of the athletes you'll be sharing about with, you know, some of their stories on the stage at ACRE? Because I think that's really powerful for people to understand.
Well, I've had the privilege of working in the highest level of sport and business. So the NHL was really my training ground. I was with 14 years, 9 years with the Edmonton Oilers in the 90s, and then tried to retire and got pulled off the bench by the St. Louis Blues and spent 4 years with them. So I'll be telling you some stories about, not specifics. I mean, it'd probably be, I don't know, thrown in jail if I tell the stories now, but I have some really relevant stories that will help real estate investors understand the mindset of an athlete is identical to the mindset of a real estate investor. Then from there I transitioned to being an Olympic performance coach in the realm of ice dance. So for some reason the ice keeps calling me. It's my happy place. So I'll be telling some stories, and mostly adversity stories. I can tell some great success stories, but you know what, to be honest, I don't know anybody that has gotten to success just by having repeated successes. It's a fantasy. So I think I'll probably sprinkle them both in, but mostly I'll be telling some stories of adversity and how my athletes overcame them.
Wonderful. Well, it's good. Really look forward to having you, Steffany. And I wanted to ask you this before we end this, this quick little talk.
Sure.
I can't wait to share the stage with you again, but yes. If somebody's sitting on, I mean, there's people watching this right now that are already coming to ACRE and people, fantastic. Congratulations. You're going to be blown away. There's other people who've decided this isn't for them and they've decided to do something else that week. But there's some people watching this thinking, should I do it? Should I not do it? Should I do it? Should I not do it? They're on the fence. What do you say to those people, Steph?
Get off the fence. You know, you can't live your life on the fence, you know, one foot on one side, one foot on the other. It's, you know, we call it striving to be mediocre, and it doesn't mean you have to be amazing and know everything. But it's, if you're on the fence, take a look at what you really want. Cause if you don't really want to come, then that's great. But if you're thinking that this, if you're even thinking that this might be something you want to do, do it. It's like when you don't want to go to the gym. The minute I go, I don't want to go to the gym, or I don't want to go do something, it's me, oh yeah, that's what I have to do. So I always go, you know what, whatever, look at what you don't want to do and then find a way to do it.
Wonderful.
Because it's in there. You want to do it. You know you do.
We'll leave it right there, Steffany. Thank you so much for your time. I totally appreciate you and appreciate you taking the time while your dancers are getting ready to go on the ice. And good luck at the Grand Prix this weekend.
Thank you very much. We'll see you soon, JG.
Have a great day. Bye-bye.
Take care. Bye-bye.